One of the other game changers that could have a significant impact is the flow of domestic money into the markets. I mean, over the past 2 years, we've seen, what, about $25 odd billion coming into the Indian markets via the domestic route. How confident do you feel about this scaling significantly forward?
I'm shouting from 2001, 2002, that, okay, foreigners, but there's going to be a tsunami of Indian money. There has to be. You know, Morgan Stanley has reported that the local money, in whatever form, mutual funds, insurance, or provident funds or individuals, was about $60 billion in the last 10 years. They are predicting between $425 billion and $825 billion in the next 10 years. And I think they're going to be right. Mm.
$425 to $825 billion over the next 10 years.
As against $60 billion. Mm. Right? So I think there will be a tsunami of money. And I think that demonetization has played a big role. Mm. Because a lot of the money was lying into cupboards has come into the banks. Mm. So people either invest it or they consume it, right? Or they leave it in the bank. Mm. So that has brought a lot of, you know, money into the formal economy.
Speaking of formalization and the formal economy, we're starting to see that happen for the real estate sector as well. We've seen the RERA bill being passed and now being operationalized. How confident do you feel about a revival and a long-term change in the real estate sector?
You know, I draw an analogy between the stock market before 94 and after 94. Hmm. The way they changed, I think the real estate sector has seen that.
That kind of change.
You know, it's impossible today to adjust any profits in the stock market. Before 94, that was all everybody did. So I think it's a very good thing. You know, any change requires adjustment and loss to certain people. But I think overall, it's a very, very correct law. Hmm. Right? And given 3, 4, 5 years, it will inspire confidence for investment in real estate. Hmm. Because people will be bound by what they commit. Hmm.
So it will still take another 3 or 5 years before you actually see a revival and a pickup as far as the sector is concerned.
And also I see a lot of consolidation. Hmm. And, you know, real estate developers will need far more capital than they need earlier. Hmm. But there will be much cleaner practices. Hmm.
So continue to reaffirm your faith in the real estate sector as well, or feel even more confident now about it?
I am bullish on the real estate sector. Hmm. Because I think, you know, the way the commercial sector, you know, peaked. You know, I was planning to buy a rented premises in BKC, and I was fighting. He wanted a, I wanted a 12% cap. He was offering an 11% cap. Hmm. Right, and I left the deal. He came to 11.5%, and today the caps are 7.5%. So, you know, values have gone up 25, 30%, 40% in the last 2 years. Hmm. Same way, I think the residential market at the economy level, 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, has already revived. I think even beyond that, I think that revival is here, it's not there.
Okay. You know, since we're talking about themes, let me pick on the theme that you just touched upon. You talked about consolidation within the real estate sector. You talked about possible consolidation within the banking sector, which is something that the government is hoping to push forward, at least as far as the PSBs are concerned. Is consolidation going to be a big theme, sector agnostic, for India over the next 3-4 years?
It is going to be a big thing. See, it requires change of people's mindsets, right? And it will take time, but I mean, government is going to push through public sector consolidation, but Mr. Chidambaram tried it 7, 8 years ago, 9 years ago. Hmm. It's not an easy thing.
So you're not holding your breath on public sector banks being consolidated?
It's not an easy thing. It won't happen post, I think it'll happen
post-2019. Post-2019. So similar skepticism then, we've heard so much about this business of strategic disinvestment and lists being drawn up and so on and so forth. Targets have been given. In fact, Mr. Panagariya, every time he does an interview with me, says, I hope it's going to happen in the next quarter, but he himself admitted that he's frustrated with the pace at which things have moved. So do you feel confident that at least maybe on the strategic disinvestment route we're going to see forward movement?
See, I told you, that this term, Mr. Modi is going to understand everything, plan everything, right? And not necessarily do everything, right? What he has done will come to fructification. I mean, the DBT, that is, right, the investment in roads, in power, the ease of doing business. But I think the big ticket, strategic disinvestments, right? I think they could be. I mean, I don't know. I have no crystal ball to say. But, you know, it will be very actively opposed by the unions. So I think labor law change. But I think if he's elected with a good majority, the second term will be a blitzkrieg.
Second term will be a blitzkrieg. So 2019, post 2019, if this government were to return to power, you believe that it's going to
absolutely
be...
Absolutely. And I think within a year or two, you'll see 10%, 11%, according to me. Because all the infrastructure investment that we are making, the kind of roads we're making in villages, the first thing to take out a village out of darkness is connectivity. Right? The Aadhaar, I think it's nowhere in the world it will happen. The digitization, the acceptance of paying tax. I mean, all this is, see, it is all points in a circle. The circle will only be complete. I mean, you know, I always believe India will have double digit growth and there will be a tsunami of local money.
Local money, yeah.
That's why I have kept all my wealth in equities. Right? I believe the day is not far away. The pandit will say, Kanhaiya ko lao, samay aa gaya hai. So I think, see, I'm very, very bullish. But, you know, as all humans, what we do is, we overestimate the immediate and underestimate the future. So we may have got too bullish, right?
Too
ahead? Very excited. Because we were
too
very
bullish, too ahead, you think?
No, in sectors, let us say housing. Now, because, you know, someone's got housing finance will boom, steel will boom, cement will boom, tiles will boom, everything will boom. Of course, they're booming. But the pace of that boom may accentuate only after some time.
So where do you believe that we're perhaps ahead in terms of exuberance? Which are the sectors that you believe
I will not comment anything on that. I will not comment it.
Not stock sectors?
No sectors. Enough of sectors.
Enough of sectors also?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me then ask you about, you were just talking about the infrastructure story, and, you know, this has largely been driven by government spending. I mean, whether it's the previous budget or this year's budget, the government continues to spend across roads, railways, etc. Private investment is yet to pick up. Do you see signs of that now?
No, but ma'am, private investment in India with these kind of interest rates, how will private investment come in interest? Be realistic, right? Today there is excess of power plants, right? Who is going to build a road if there is no return on equity? There is so much competition. All those who bought the tolls are not doing well, right? So you could require long-term money, like the Canadian Pension Fund, the government money. Who is going to invest with the railways? I don't think anybody is going to invest, right?
So then the infrastructure story, from a private investment point of view, you think that it continues
to have no takers? Private investment can come in steel, it can come in cement, it can come in so many areas.
But not in...
It can come in cars, it can come in tractors, it can come in so many capital goods, right? So that doesn't mean that but the primary spending of infrastructure money...
will be driven by government.
Government and by pension funds. Because a pension fund can look at an 8% return over a 30-year period. A private investor won't. But I think the effects of the infrastructure is going to be tremendous. See, one of the biggest problems in India is the electricity distribution. Today we have power plants, but there's nobody to sign a PPA with because the electric companies can't pay distribution companies. So unless we do all over what Mr. Modi has done in Gujarat, it'll be very difficult to have power for everybody. You may have the power, but there will be nobody to buy it. I think all these problems are getting addressed. They'll take time, right? And I think in UP, I think the administration, law and order position, the cleanliness of the administration is, whatever Mr. Adinath is, a decisive man, he's a clean man. He's going to clean up, in my opinion. Not
You're confident about
101%.
That? 101%. On what basis?
On his track record,
But he hasn't been an administrator.
No, but he is. This is my judgment. You don't have, in the stock market, you don't wait for the event to happen. You predict it, and I can always know. I think he'll be a clean, good administrator. Number one. And people's face change when they come into power for the good. Because when you are on the road, you can say anything, shout anything. When you have power, you cannot.